Hi, welcome back to Wesbury 101. I'm Brian Wesbury, Chief Economist at First Trust Portfolios. Remember, we want to be the antidote to conventional wisdom. Well, conventional wisdom looked at the May decline of 1.5% in existing home sales. That came out yesterday and said, see, we told you the economy is slowing down. And on its face, you'd say they're absolutely right. But if you go read the realtors' report on existing home sales for May, what you quickly find out is that the reason existing home sales were weak in May was because that there is a shortage. There's a shortage of existing homes on the market. Inventories have plummeted. Overall, existing home inventories are down 20% in the past year. They peaked at over 4 million back in 2007. They're now down to 2.5 or 2.49 million. And just take a look at this chart. This is single family home inventory, so it doesn't include condos or co-ops or apartment buildings. We are now at the lowest level of inventory since April of 2005. And if you look at the past 30 years, we're kind of right along the average line. There's no excess inventories in the market. Now, this is also true in the new home market. Here's another chart, single family new homes, inventories of unsold single family new homes. They're at the lowest level we have seen since this data was started, since it was begun to be collected back in 1962. So we have 50 years of data. This is the lowest level of inventories. And we believe that low level of inventories of new homes is holding back new home sales as well. Now, just for the record, we predicted that we would have shortages a few years ago. We were laughed at by many people, but it is coming to fruition now. Now, how could we have said we would have shortages? Well, it's not that hard if you've watched the economy over the last 30 or 40 or 50 years or read any history about economics, because every time a market is traumatized, we always get less investment than we should, and eventually what happens, prices start to go up and shortages develop. It's happening in the housing market. It was predictable, and it's happening today. Housing has begun to turn. Demand for homes has picked up consistently over the past year, in fact, a little bit more than a year. Take a look at this table. It lists all the different numbers we have for housing. Existing home sales are up 9.6% from last year. New homes are up 9.9%, those sales are. Housing starts up 28.5%. Building permits for future building activity up 25% over the past year and 48% at an annualized rate over the past 3 months. Now, we added a three-month annualized column on here because what's happening is that shortages in those markets are holding us back in some areas, but also the weaknesses in multifamily units. In other words, the single-family market is picking up consistently over the past year. Now, that leads me to just one point, and that is, remember all of those people who said we could not have a recovery in the economy without a housing recovery. Well, we are now seeing the housing recovery. And I know that some of those people who waited for this are now saying we can't have a recovery or we're going to head back into recession. We don't believe it. Housing is picking up. Building activity is picking up. It's added to GDP for four consecutive quarters. This will be the fifth quarter, and we expect it will continue to add for the rest of this year and into 2013 and beyond. This will be added to consumption, added to investment. The slowdown we're seeing in data today is in fact less than the slowdown we saw back in 2011. This pause, we do not believe is sliding into recession. We believe it's a slowdown like we've seen in 2010, again in 2011, and we're going to see it again this year. In fact, we already are, but we do not expect a recession. We expect the economy to come out, and housing will be one of the sectors that leads the way. Thanks so much for visiting Wesbury 101. We'll see you next time.